So this next story is one, if you are doing something else, sit down and watch this one. It is so inspiring. This Akron area teenage diver is defying all odds. His road to recovery is nothing short of remarkable.
Fox 8 sports reporter John Sable joins us now live in the studio with much more on this pretty inspiring story here, John.
Yeah, guys, this story is incredible. Now, we all encounter different types of adversity throughout our entire lives, but it's really how we react and persevere through those tough times that really make up who we are. 14-year-old Elijah Harper learned that at a very young age. His story of survival has shaped who he is on and off the diving board.
You wouldn't know it by the look of this near-perfect dive that 14-year-old Elijah Harper just recently started diving. And by recently, I mean he just started diving 4 months ago after years of gymnastics.
A scale of 1 to 10, how easy it was to transition him from gymnastics to diving, I'd say around 7.5, 8. He's able to jump. He knows the flipping. That comes easy to him.
The Ellet freshman just recently completed his first Division I district meet. And while he didn't make the cut to advance, Elijah and his family will still consider this feat and everything else he'll accomplish from this day forward in his life a win. All because of what he endured nearly 7 years ago.
His balance was a little off. He was getting headaches here and there. I was dizzy and my head hurt.
Elijah's mom rushed him to the hospital thinking her son had a concussion, but the diagnosis turned out to be more serious.
They ran me through a CAT scan and then they found a mass in my head.
A brain tumor, a little bigger than the size of an egg, called medulloblastoma, was pressing up against Elijah's cerebellum and his brainstem.
I thought I was gonna like die.
Spinal fluid would have been shut off within like days, I guess. So he would have been dead like that within days.
He had emergency surgery, and thankfully, doctors at Akron Children's Hospital successfully removed the cancerous tumor. No cancer cells were left behind. Elijah started 6 weeks of radiation in Chicago and a year of chemotherapy back home, and then came the rehab.
I had to teach him pretty much almost kind of like he had to start walking again.
Elijah is currently cancer-free.
He shouldn't be here right now. Like, this is, he's a miracle.
Elijah's journey to the diving board may have just started only 4 months ago, but years before that, including 3 surgeries, countless hours of chemotherapy and radiation, after all he's been through, his story is an inspiration to many.
He's overcome more than any of us will ever get to experience overcoming. It's huge. He definitely is inspiring to everybody.
If I didn't have a brain tumor, then I'd probably not be as strong as I am now.
Wow, strong kid right there. Now, Elijah Harper has CT scans every year to make sure the cancer hasn't returned. And he's been cancer-free now for nearly 6 years. His type of brain cancer occurs most often in children under the age of 15, with the majority of the cases impacting kids between 3 and 9 years old. Natalie and Gabe, he got diagnosed right around 8 years old, right before he turned 9. So this young man has been through so much, and then finally he's good, he's happy, he's doing a lot of different sports, and his mom cannot be any happier and thrilled, and she credits a lot of his recovery to his determination and their faith.
Yeah, he seems cool as a cucumber. Love the name, by the way. My son's name's Elijah, too, but he seems like he's taking it in stride because this kid's seen so many hospitals, knows so many doctors and nurses. He seems to be taking it in stride.
Yeah, he really did, and when you think about it, going to Chicago for the radiation and coming back here for the surgeries, and he just had 3 surgeries, and he had a port in place in his chest that he had to take all of the different medications and the chemotherapy. I mean, for a young child to go through that, I mean, it's just tough, and he's really resilient.
He said it perfectly. He knows. He said, if it wasn't for this cancer, I wouldn't be as strong as I am. He has gone through so much that nothing he sets out to accomplish is going to be fearful for him. He will accomplish it and then some.
And to learn that at 14 is just impressive.